after the car is found, they bring all the dogs in. Well, the dogs, they go right over the berm into the quarry. The dogs track deeper into the quarry on the southwest section of it, and then they come back up to exactly where her car is found, through that conveyor road up onto the Avery property. And those dogs are not reacting to her remains, they're reacting to her scent.
Thank you.
They go over and they all converge on the suspected burial site. They ultimately declare there's nothing relevant about it. But nobody really questions that the dogs, both the scent and the cadaver dogs, alert over there. Isn't it possible that Teresa's car with her body was parked in there for a few hours before she's burned? Or is she laid out on the soil and maybe just barely covered up? I want to figure out with that berm, because I feel like that's where they came through. You know, we spend a lot of time on those scent dogs tracking in the quarry.
That's where they're really hitting is, yeah. Is that quarry.
And then there were bones over there.
Mm-hmm. You know. Better to know either.
Yeah. No, there was a pelvis over there.
Okay.
And there's a lot of stuff over there.
I've had the opportunity to observe a number of human cadavers burned under a variety of conditions. And I know what it takes to keep a body burning and what it takes to accomplish a certain amount of destruction.
And again, it all goes back to what he taught me years ago, over a decade ago, is it's atmosphere. It's a flat pit. It's really not protected on the sides or anything. So all the energy is going to the atmosphere. And so there's nothing concentrating that fire. Or keeping a fire next to the body.
So to have flames in an open area 12 or 15 feet high or higher would require an enormous fuel load.
What kind of fuel would be required? How many gallons would you have?
You'd have to have a continuous supply. You'd have to
have, hundreds of gallons, yes. Right? You'd have to have your fuel tank.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's huge, though, because, I mean, the state told the jury that the remnants of a couple tires were found. And that the body could actually be essentially cremated with tires put on it as the fuel source. I mean, do you think that's possible?
This looks like the remains of maybe two tires. Well, those will help keep a body burning, but they are not going to be a primary fuel to achieve this kind of destruction. If you're fueling it with dozens of car tires, you're going to have visible remains of all the steel elements of the car tires. And you'd also have, if you're fueling this with solid fuels, you're going to have a lot of ash.
If you're going to burn up a body and have a huge fire for hours, just think about it, you're going to have debris everywhere. And it may not even be body debris, but something, there's going to be other stuff burning. And you should be able to see what some of that is.
So when we talk about negative evidence, so there's just a complete absence of any fuel source that would have reduced the body to this state that it's discovered in.
That's right. The other thing is, if you keep a fire burning with a human cadaver, no matter what kind of fuel you're adding, the combustion of the tissue, especially the fat, creates a black, brown goo, and so you're going to end up with a stain when you burn a body on open ground.
So at this scene, if they'd had any experts present, this whole theory might never have gotten off the ground, right?
That's right. Any experienced crime scene person would be able to recognize that the thermal damage and the residual materials that should be present if there was a large fire here enough to consume a body.